So, Katie, you told everybody about training and test sets, and I hope people exercise it quite a bit. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right.
So now I'm going to talk about something that slightly generalizes this, called cross-validation. And to get into cross-validation, let's first talk about problems with splitting a data set into training and testing data. Suppose this is your data. By doing what Katie told you, you now have to say what fraction of data is testing and what is training. And the dilemma you're running into is you'd like to maximize both of those sets. You want to have as many data points in the training set to get the best learning results. And you want a maximum number of data items in your test set to get the best validation. But obviously there's an inherent trade-off here, which is every data point you take out of the training set into the test set is lost for the training set. So where do you set this trade-off? And this is where cross-validation came into the picture. The basic idea is that you partition your data set into k bins of equal size. So example, if you have 200 data points and you have 10 bins, very quickly, what's the number of data points per bin? Quite obviously, it's 20. So you would have 20 data points in each of the 10 bins. So here's the picture. Whereas in the work that Katie showed you, you just pick one of those bins as a testing bin and the other nine as a training bin. In k-fold cross-validation, you run k separate learning experiments. In each of those, you pick one of those k subsets as your testing set. The remaining k minus one bins are put together into the training set. Then you train your machine learning algorithm, and just like before, you test the performance on the testing set. The key thing in cross-validation is you run this multiple times, in this case, 10 times, and then you average the 10 different testing set performances for the 10 different holdout sets. So you average the test results from those k experiments. So obviously this takes more compute time because you now have to run k separate learning experiments, but the assessment of your learning algorithm will be more accurate. And in a way, you've kind of used all your data for training and all your data for testing, which is kind of cool. So let me just ask one question. Suppose you have a choice to do the static train test methodology that Kay told you about, or you do, say, tenfold cross-validation, CV. And you really care about minimizing training time, minimize runtime after training, using your machine learning algorithm to output past the train time, and maximize accuracy. In each of these three situations, you might pick either train test or tenfold cross-validation. Give me your best guess, which one would you pick? So for each minimum training time, pick one of the two over here on the right side.